I am Liz Wright. Welcome to Live Your Best Life. The only thing that matters now is living by the power of this wonderful new creation life. We're going to become an undefeatable force of radiating glory, and we are rising up strong now in this hour. Hello, family. Thank you for tuning in to this week's what's going to be a really special, really different. It's a treat for you today's episode of course, Live Your Best Life with me, Liz Wright. And I have one of my beautiful friends joining me for today's conversation. It's going to be about really empowering you with prophetic revelation, and we're going to pray for you. As many of you will know, there is a real move of Holy Spirit that we are stewarding in our midst at the moment in our international mentoring community. We've had many, many now thousands collectively of testimonies, and most recently of testimonies where people are being literally set free from decades of trauma in an instant through experiencing Jesus. And so many more miracles. We'll share more in a moment, but I just wanted to encourage you all today. Today is going to be really special. So if you can, we're going to flow with Holy Spirit, and our focus is His heart and you, and just that you will get your miracle. You will get your breakthrough. You will get your encounter. So my beautiful friend joining me today, she is the founder of Heart of Gold Ministries, based in Alaska, co-founder with her amazing husband. She's also been recently ordained by the beautiful Emma Stark, who many of you know and love. We absolutely love Emma. She's one of our core founding members of the international mentoring community. She's an internationally loved prophet. I mean, she's a mum, she's a wife, she's just an amazing woman of God. And above everything, she loves Jesus. But yeah, she's a woman, like I said, of great love and great wisdom. And she is absolutely part of the glue. She's that holds all that we do together. The way she loves everyone is inspirational. So it's my joy to welcome into the conversation with me today, the beautiful Stephanie Claiborne. Stephanie, welcome.
Oh my goodness. What a beautiful introduction. Thank you, my friend.
Oh, you are so welcome. I mean, every word of it. So just wanted to, so for those of you that have not experienced the IMC and not part of our international mentoring community family, I just want to begin by us talking, Stephanie, a little bit about what the experience is like and how Holy Spirit's moving, like from your perspective. And then I just would love us to share a little bit as well, which we can move into, of the way the Lord's speaking to us as well, because we'll specifically pray for you guys today to get this revelation, to begin to step into this same way Holy Spirit's moving, same experience. So, yeah. So from your perspective, what is the IMC like?
Wow. Well, you know, Liz, from my perspective, when I joined the IMC, like, I think it was almost 3 years ago.
Yeah.
It feels like it was almost 3 years ago. I knew it was a different space and that God was creating something so holy, but so special. And it wasn't like any other type of space. You know, you can join this network, you join that network. And it wasn't like, you know, you had to take courses and you had to do all this. You just had to be mentored by the Holy Spirit. And watching how the Lord just flowed through you to all the community, there's nothing like it. And so watching over the last several years how it's grown, for one, but then also the testimonies, because people are coming into deep encounter with Jesus.
Yeah.
When people see Jesus and they're able to apprehend His presence, there's nothing like it. And you can't go back from there. Once you encounter Him like that, you can't go back. And so from my perspective, watching people blossom and watching people step into their true identity, and watching also how people have been able to shed old mindsets and old perspectives of themselves. And it's like you're watching people be reborn.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
It's incredible. It's really incredible. Yeah. And it makes me just smile when I think of the IMC, when people tell me, you know, oh, I just joined the IMC, or what is the IMC like? I can't help but smile, because knowing what Jesus is doing in our midst, I mean, it's a miracle.
Yeah,
it's literally a miracle.
Yeah, it is. I mean, honestly, 3 years ago, approximately, like you said, like Jesus said to me, if I create a space for him, he would come. And he really has. I mean, he's just blown us away. Like every single week, whether I'm speaking on our live times, which is an hour live every single Friday, or I have one of our guest speakers on, and then on, you know, Saturday every month, then our intercessors and founders jump on and pray for everybody. And literally every week, it's like, you know, we let go and Holy Spirit takes over and his spirit starts to move. And people who've never had encounters with Jesus in their life are having radical encounters. And some people have been in church for years and not got that sensory awareness of his presence and to be able to live from the strength of union. And that's what's happening. And bodies healed and emotions healed and trauma healed. I've just got to read you. So I just want to glorify Jesus and encourage you guys as well. You know, with, I'll just read you a couple of the most recent of the testimonies that are just like, yeah, all glory to Jesus. And same Holy Spirit is inside of you right now. So just listen to these and be encouraged and just let it build up your faith for your own miracle and breakthrough today. So a couple of weeks ago, I was suddenly overwhelmed as I encountered Jesus during an IMC lifetime call, which is our Friday calls. I felt both trauma and pain leaving my body without having to relive those traumatic moments. I'm so grateful to the Lord for this increased freedom. And then it goes on. Isn't that amazing? Wowza! Yes, yes. I mean, we've pressed in for these kind of miracles for years. We've been praying for them, and not that people in, you know, many of us who go through massive trauma, right, Stephanie? And you know that from the work you've done in this area over the years, that is an absolute life-transforming miracle. That's a reset of your heart, and only that only God can do. So couple more very quickly for you. I was where is the next one? Just let me pull this up really quickly for you. Belonging to the international mentoring community has exposed my heart to realms of love and light I never knew existed. The stress, anxiety, and depression I once found a home in have lost their grip on my life. Jesus, you are amazing. So there's more, there's loads more. But anyway, I'll stop there for now. But you get the idea. This is a very, like you said, Stephanie, very pure, very holy way the Holy Spirit's moving. And he's really also freshly igniting our faith.
Yes.
So that we're no longer, right, living in intermittent faith, but we're living consistently from the strength of our union, more and more and more continually living by faith, not by sight, with great hope again, Reese, and courage, right? Boldness and courage that comes from that fresh awareness in our hearts that he is faithful. He is within us. It's his faith moving through us, you know, and therefore we begin to realize the promises manifesting in our lives because we're reset into receive mode. But yeah, and I know, Stephanie, you've just released a word on the Elijah list around this same theme of faith, there's faith and hope. And when we're in wilderness seasons, and, you know, it's just it's a brilliant, brilliant divine perspective. Will you just share a little bit about that, what the Lord's been showing you?
Yes. And actually, when we were together on one of the lifetimes at a Saturday prayer time, the Lord actually downloaded that for me, to me. And because sometimes we have a perspective of being in the wilderness that God has left, or that we're isolated, or that we're alone, or, you know, this is a testing trial time. And, you know, there's the worldly perspective, but the Lord is saying, lean on me during this time, because the scripture that it came from was in Song of Solomon. And, you know, her friends were saying, who is this coming out of the wilderness looking like her beloved? Who is this? She was unrecognizable.
Wow. That's
and she was in, isn't that profound? She was in her wilderness, but she learned to lean at that time on her beloved. She leaned on Jesus, right? As we lean on Jesus, we become unrecognizable. The pain that was supposed to distort us then comes, and then it's Jesus turns it around, and we end up looking like our beloved. Wow. As we lean, as we come up out of the wilderness, leaning on our beloved. The part that just really struck me was that her friends didn't even recognize her.
Yeah. Yeah. Because she was so transformed.
She was transformed. She was transfigured. She was, you know, and so when we take the opportunities, just like the people in the IMC who are taking the opportunity to lean into what the Lord is doing. Yeah. And even if they don't understand that season that they're in, and as they're leaning in, they're coming out with these testimonies that are just profound, Liz. Yeah. They are profound. It's amazing.
Yeah. Yeah. It's holy ground. It's holy ground. It's okay. I want to be able to just stop there for a moment, Stephanie, and for us to pray. So if you guys are struggling with unbelief, with overwhelm, let's start there. And to just agree that fresh faith ignites inside of you and your heart can, you know, lean, just rest, just lean into him. Like you just mentioned, Stephanie, you know, Song of Solomon, chapter 8, the Shulamite comes out of the wilderness, right? Huge key. We come out of the wilderness, leaning,
that's right.
Through leaning. Yeah, there's no way around this. Holy Spirit is determined to have us all living by faith, not by sight. Yes. Having learned too the wisdom of leaning, right? Of that life where faith is just the constant internal posture of the heart. That's yes. Where he's taking us to. So no matter how extreme the circumstances, how extreme the world circumstances are for you or collectively at large, we're in rest, right? We're just in rest. And he's doing this. He's doing this. He's removing stress and anxiety and overwhelm and fear and unbelief and all this stuff that's warred against us. And he's resetting us, right, to that deep, deep place. So do you want to flow? Stephanie, do you want to jump off? And we'll just pray. We'll pray for you all. So just receive this. If you've got zero faith, it's fine. If you're absolutely worn out, or if you've got loads, there's always more, right? There's always more. But yeah, faith, peace, boldness. This is
yes. Yes.
See a reset happen now. It's Holy Spirit's heart.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. And so, Lord, we just thank you that in our wilderness times, Lord, you're showing us how to lean, Lord. Father, we thank you for the invitation that you've provided for us, Lord. And I thank you, Holy Spirit. You're giving us the strength and the ability to lean into you, Lord. Father, I thank you that for all that are listening, Lord, that you're provoking something inside of them, Lord, that wants to be joined with you, Lord. And I thank you, God, that you're bringing us into a deeper place of understanding of who you are. And I thank you, Lord, that wilderness place, Lord, is a place of flourishing and blossoming. Lord, even blossoms bloom in the desert places, Lord. And so I thank you, God, that you are bringing people into a deeper revelation of who you are and whose they are, Lord. Thank you, God, for surrounding us right now with your precious Holy Spirit. Thank you, Lord.
Wow, wow, wow. His heavy presence. Wow. Getting thicker and thicker right now. Oof, holy, 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 holy. Oof, holy, holy, holy. Can feel his joy. Wow. Bubbling up inside. The joy of the Lord is our strength. Wow, wow, wow. I find as well, as I know you do, Stephanie, when the joy comes, when his joy, I can feel it. Literally, I feel at the moment like I'm going to explode because I can feel Holy Spirit wanting to just like release and saturate you and convince you of the love that Father Jesus and Holy Spirit have for you, that you are the apple of the Lord's eye, that you are absolutely loved. You're absolutely safe. Holy Spirit is within you and does want to meet your every single need and does want to break you free today and will do, is doing. But yeah, with the joy, Stephanie, I know for me, and I know that we've talked about this before, but when the joy starts to come, as many of you will know, it breaks the religious spirit.
Yes.
It breaks the power of the religious spirit and it breaks off fear and overwhelm. So if you've got anxiety and yeah, the Lord, you know, if you're feeling really weak and worn out and just like there's impossibilities just pressing you and screaming at you. The Lord's coming as your strength right now as well. Oh, Holy Spirit. Oh, Holy Spirit. We agree. We agree. There's a scripture that you actually included when you released that word, Stephanie, on Elijah list, Proverbs 3:5-8. Oh my gosh. This is super famous, so well known, so powerful. I just want to read it quickly, and I encourage you to do the word, right? Just step in, come in agreement with this with your heart. Holy Spirit, oof, and the Lord will just keep taking you deeper. Like I always say, you know, we know to do, like you just use the doorway. The word is the doorway in. Lock the attention of your heart right now even more completely onto Jesus within you as we just then read the word and come in agreement with it. And he'll just, he'll take you deeper again. Trust the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your understanding. Holy, holy, holy. Woohoo, there's his presence. And in all your ways, submit to him, and he will make your path straight. Do not be wise in your own eyes. Fear the Lord and shun evil. This will bring health to your body and nourishment to your bones. So the scripture there saying, do not be wise in your own eyes, just means lean. Just look to him, right, Stephanie, as our source, as your source, the one who wants to meet every single need that can break you free from stress and overwhelm in a moment and is doing right now. So don't lean on you. Lean on him. Just let go on the inside right now. Just sink into his presence. He's already there. He's already within you. Holy, 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 holy. Just reject the ways of darkness. Say, I want nothing to do with any of it, darkness anymore at all. Wow. Oof, Holy Spirit. I just felt the Lord like detaching us.
Yeah.
Any of us right now, could you feel that, Stephanie? Like any of you that are compromised, that feel, yeah, that there's just a grip of darkness in your heart, there's attitudes within you, emotional attitudes or ways of thinking, belief systems that would be an open door, like provide a landing place for the enemy, or just follow the enemy, they'll just shut the enemy off then. So just break agreement with the ways of darkness. Submit to him, trust him as your source all over again. Can't you feel his invitation, Stephanie, right now? He's like, just let go. This is happening. This change is happening inside right now so that the health to your body, the nourishment to your bones can begin to happen. The healing can flow as you just let go and trust him. Holy. Wow.
Wow. Wow. Wow. Wow. Wow.
Joy. More joy.
Yes. Exactly. And I just, you know, as you were reading that, I just had another thought, you know, of the Shulamite coming out of the wilderness, leaning on her beloved. Her beloved never left.
Uh-huh. Right.
And so many times people in the wilderness think, where is God? I don't see him. I don't know where he's at, but he never left. And our own understanding keeps us separate. It tries to create this barrier between us and the Lord. And that's why the Lord is just saying, just lean on me and not on your own understanding. And I just find it so profound that the Lord would just put this in scripture as instruction for us.
Yeah.
And as we lean, it's also another way of surrender. Because, and you and I have talked about this before too, that it's a whole nother level of surrender that the Lord is requiring, that he's asking of us.
Yeah.
And so, yeah.
Yeah. Do you want to pray for grace for that, fresh grace for that? Because this is where this is what he's talking about in IMC. It's where he's taking us, where we truly are in this place completely in rest, trusting him all the time. So that all the promises of God can manifest in our lives, because cascade, his blessings cascade. He wants us strong, right, Stephanie? He wants us, yeah, ruling.
Yes.
Place, victorious, holy, 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 holy.
Yes. So, Holy Spirit, we just thank you. We thank you for the fresh grace being poured out. I'm just seeing grace being poured out like honey right now over people, over the IMC, over people listening to this. Fresh grace to be able to surrender. And so, Lord, I thank you, God, that we are stepping into a new level of grace with you, Father. A new level of grace so that, Father, we can step into who we are designed to be in you. And thank you, Lord, that you are helping us to not lean on our own understanding in this time, but that we're leaning on you, our beloved. Thank you, Lord, for your anointing to do so. And thank you, Lord God, that you're breaking off every single yoke. Whew. That has tried to prevent people from leaning, Lord, that yokes are coming off, veils are being lifted and removed in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord.
Wow. When you were praying then, Stephanie, I started to go into a vision and I saw all of us, like some of us were kind of teetering back towards looked like many, many thrones in a circle above our nations. And so we may feel very inadequate for that task right now of seated in heavenly places, enthroned as a governmental voice, as one who moves in intimacy with Jesus and authority is an overflow of his heart, oracles of his heart. But I saw, so we might feel very weak, but I saw as we were praying, what the Lord's doing is he's causing us to retake our position. We already are there, but he's tuning our conscious awareness back in and he's aligning us on the inside. So all the bumps and bruises and pain and stuff that has caused us to feel overwhelmed and we felt impotent in our ability to operate effectively and to live by faith, not by sight, and to release the word of God with power and confidence. All of that is being resolved by Jesus right now because he's calling us. And even though some of us looked pretty weak in the vision, we were steadily moving back and taking our position where some of us, whatever, we've abdicated our positional authority. We've been knocked off our throne temporarily in our awareness. Jesus is bringing everybody back. He's causing the bride to take up her position so that we together, collectively, as one. Another thing he's doing with us as well, Stephanie, is he's creating supernatural unity. So I saw that as well. We were united. We were one voice. We were full of love. We were yielded to the King and we were operating in power and authority. So amen. We call you back into position right now. We thank you, Holy Spirit, for every one of our brothers and sisters that has been temporarily disengaged or felt that they've been very ineffective. We call everybody back into their seat of authority to decree your heart over their family, over their communities, over their relationships, over their ministries, over their jobs, over their lives, and over the nations collectively. Wow. Thank you, Jesus. One's leaning, leaning royalty, shining Jesus. Wow. We call you forth at this time as one predestined to be alive right now. And I also was mindful of the scripture where the disciples were all together after Pentecost had happened and the persecution had broken out. It's recorded in the book of Acts. It's where the disciples went back into a prayer meeting and they asked Jesus to fill them with boldness. I felt the Lord doing that too. So we take up our position and as we step by faith back into position, trusting him, leaning, going into ever deepening rest, we are going to start to see such a manifestation of supernatural boldness and confidence because we know the one we're leaning into is in charge, is the king. Okay, so I wanted to ask you as well, Stephanie, we've also been getting physical healings, emotional healings, encounters, physical healings. So will you pray, Stephanie, for the physical, those of the family right now, those of you that really need healing because obviously we've seen a tremendous amount of fruit in this area.
Yes, absolutely. So Lord, I thank you that that physical healing is actually happening, Lord God. It's not beyond your reach to heal, Lord. And so I thank you, Father, that people are beginning to be healed. Anyone listening to this right now, Lord, I thank you that you are reaching them. You're anointing. I just see oil being poured out. Father, I thank you that you are healing bodies right now, where there's been obstacles, where there's been delay, where there's been things that have come against faith. Lord, I thank you, Lord God, that you are healing bodies right now. And you're going beyond even our reasoning, our thought, Lord, that you're going way beyond that, Lord God. And you're going deep into the recesses of each body and you're healing. Thank you for the anointing to heal right now. Thank you for miracles that are happening. The workers of miracles are arising. Thank you, Lord God, that people are stepping into their healing and stepping into their call, Lord God, as healers in Jesus' name. Wow.
Oh, amen.
Wow.
When you were praying then, Stephanie, I could see Holy Spirit moving through every single one of us. Of course, he's within us, mm-hmm. right? As yes. white light. And he was just spreading out. And it looked like thousands and thousands of roads within us, because he was just moving his light through every single system and cell. And then I saw Jesus specifically touching the mitochondria in the cell. So that's the, for those of you who are not familiar with the language, that is the energy generator inside each one of our cells. So I saw that, the energy generator being healed by Jesus, so that your vitality, your energy, your efficiency physically, all of it being restored. So we thank you, Jesus, for that miracle as well right now. As Stephanie and I come in agreement, we thank you. Every system and cell in the body completely healed. And I could see the Lord, as well as you were praying, Stephanie, just moving through the nervous system, removing trauma, which we've seen him do. And then we see the trauma go. And so we thank you, Jesus, for held trauma within your physical body, tension, anxiety, overwhelm. Just, you know, how we go stiff and rigid, and we don't even realize it till, you know, we become aware. It's like, oh yeah, I'm actually aching because I'm so stressed. So right now we pray for that complete release of his peace, of his spirit inside of you, and peace, a reset into peace, nervous systems filled with peace, minds filled with peace, hearts filled with peace. Like Jesus said to his disciples, my peace, my shalom, I give you, as he breathed on them. He's breathing within you afresh by his spirit right now, the ruach, breath of life. Like he breathed into Adam's nostrils and Adam became a living being. He's breathing afresh inside you life right now, and restoring and resetting your system, resetting you into abundant life, vitality, energy, hope. Ooh, Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit. Like the word you brought, Stephanie, one's coming out of the wilderness of our life circumstances, leaning, so that we're yes. leaning and we're reigning irrespective of what's going on. We start to bring the solution to the situations, not try to cope because the situations are overwhelming us. That is the shift. We're going to see a change because we're reigning, because we see him more clearly now and live by faith, not by sight. Healed, whole, right?
Yes.
Radiating him, just being living testimonies of hope, living the supernatural life, beginning to taste the age that's to come now. Ooh. Amen. Amen. Wow. Holy, 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 more than we have. For such a time as this, it's an important time in history for us to shine, because he is the solution and it's our watch, right? And he wants yes. us all whole. So we believe today, we believe with you, full manifestation of all the miracles, the encounters, everything he wants to pour into your life. So we have about 30 seconds, Stephanie. Is there anything else you want to pray or proclaim as we finish?
Wow. I'm just reminded of how, you know, all of this is bringing us into a more purer life yeah. with him, so we can live as the pure, spotless bride.
Fantastic. Amen. It's Amen. The truth. It's the truth. That's yeah. the hope set before us, right? Our yes. future is secure. The pure, spotless bride, the wife of the Lamb. And we're being made ready, and Holy Spirit's not going to fail that. That's his mission, right? So, amen. Amen. Thank you, Stephanie. You're amazing. I love being together.
Oh, I love you. Thank you so much.
Love you too. And guys, have the most amazing week. Stay with him if you can just now, just soak a little bit more. Keep revisiting Proverbs 3:5-8, and just do the word, step in, and you're going to see a whole new level. Yeah. Opening up into your experience with him. So, amen. Have the most amazing week, and I'll see you next week. God bless.
Many people know in their head that they're loved, but the experience of God's love hasn't reached their heart. That's why I wrote my most recent book, Loved. It's a 90-day devotional that gives you language to actually escort you into experiencing the love of God, which is the moment where everything changes for us. So I encourage you, pick up a copy of Love today, and your life